In this video, we'll explore the Settings tab inside the Form Builder. These settings make global changes to your form. You can rename your form, redirect customers after they've filled the form out, or decide what type of account gets created for customers who fill out the form. Let's jump right in. In the General Settings section, we can change the name of our form. This name is only for your reference. Customers won't see it. By checking the Mark Required Fields box, you can add an asterisk on each field that you've marked as required. The final option here allows customers to reset their password once they're logged into their account. With the redirect settings, you can decide what page customers land on once they've completed a form. This can be a success page if you check this box, or you can enter a URL here too. If you want them to go back to the previous page they were on in your store, check the Go to Previous Page box here instead. Same goes for the cancel button. If a customer cancels out of a form, these settings direct where they go once they've canceled. For account options, we have three choices. We can stick with the default, which automatically creates a customer record in Shopify and then allows customers to edit their account once they're logged in. Or we can select Require Email Verification here, which will send an account invite email through Shopify. Customers will then need to confirm via their email before they can activate their account. And lastly, you can require account approval. If this is selected, a customer's account will not get activated until you approve them in the Customers tab. One way we've seen this used is for wholesale stores that want to ensure an account is only created for qualifying businesses. To make sure this form aligns with your brand voice, we've also added a language section. Here you have the ability to globally change the wordage on various interactions. Near the bottom, we have the advanced section, and this gets pretty technical, but it adds additional functionality for developers and power users. You can deep dive into these features in our developer docs linked in the description. And finally, in the backup section at the bottom, you can download a copy of the entire form for safekeeping. You can also backup a form and import it into another Shopify store that has customer fields installed. So we made it through the Settings tab. In our next video, we will look at installing the form to our store. I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks for watching.